Please welcome Moveo, Activate, and Augies.
Thank you. My name is Andres Trin, I'm the CEO of Moveo. My kids used to love playing outside with me, but with all the new technology and mobile phones and iPads, they were just starting to sit around and playing video games. And that's also the case with other kids, where 97% of kids today are now playing video games every day. And this is causing huge mental problem, and people, like kids are becoming from passive to obese, and it's also they have stopped developing their sensor processing and have stopped being creative. And also, Boy Scouts are a thing of the past. Kids don't socialize anymore, and like, they don't have any real life experience. And on the other side, parents today don't have the time and energy to negotiate with the kids, let's go outside and let's spend quality time together. So that's why we had created an educational augmented reality platform that is like similar to Pokemon Go, getting the kids outside. But instead of chasing Pokemons, we show them like exciting educational content. So to augment content, we're using Apple AR Kit, with which we can engage and have like much better engagement with kids. And for with Google Cloud Vision, we can point people to specific location, say, take a photo, let's say, of a cat, of like a picket fence, and then we do the object recognition, give them feedback, and say where to go next. So basically, with new technology, we can have like much better engagement and learning outcome. To activate the kids, we're using avatar that correlates with their activities. So the more they walk, the more they learn, the better avatar looks. So here you can see an example, like we went outside and he's teaching kids how to tap a ball, and he's like super emotional, fit and strong. But I haven't gone out with him like for a week, and he's coming like all grungy and like fat. And this is like something that stimulates the parents mostly, because kids wants to look at it like that. So in order to reward the kids for doing their accomplishments, we give them like special in-app purchases with like points with which they can use like at some in-app games or like unlock new levels. But for other, in order for us to make this successful, what we have to do and we are doing now is getting the contracts with book authors and book publishers and also NGOs and entertainment companies where we want to take their content that is now in textbooks or like any kind of digital media and transform that into AR experience and bring that to life. Because there's so many content already there and new will gonna happen and it has to be AR. So we have two revenue models. On the platform level, we go to the publishers and say, you have the content, let's do a revenue share model, and we're gonna split the profit, and we charge the subscription model to users. On business to business, we go to the, let's say, big brands and say, we can do white label product for you, and it's all in your hands. So comparing ourselves with the competition, we're the only one that is providing educational content outside, is like able to get the whole family together to play a game, let's say do a scavenger hunt in the afternoon. But the most important, we use only 5% of screen time. That's much less intrusive to other gaming companies. The team has been working on this for the last 3 years. We raised $250,000 and have generated over 100,000 revenue. We have strong advisory team that is covering all the aspects of the business and is also dedicated for us to succeed. We launched the MVP new generation of product in November in San Francisco and had been since then focusing on getting the contract with publishing companies, entertainment companies to develop our first games, and we're gonna launch the first game in June 2018 and then continue to add the platform, the new content. So I would like to finish this with an ask, if you have some interesting content or know somebody that we could take that content and transform that in AR, please talk to me after the presentation. Thank you. Any questions? Okay.
What kinds of games and interactive experiences do you
So the game that we are working, we are developing a disaster preparedness game, meaning we went to a book author that is teaching kids how to handle in case of a fire. So we go in their environment, teach, let's say to a kid, find a fire extinguisher at your home. So he's going there, he's taking a photo, we do like an object recognition show, we know how to use the fire extinguisher. Then he has to find like different objects in his environment, and then saying, okay, now you have like a passing test if you really went through what you have to do. And then we do a simulation. So let's imagine, now we put the whole room on fire, everything is in flame, and then he's got like 15 seconds to find a fire extinguisher, like taking a photo, coming back and putting out the fire. So basically it's a real life experience that like they cannot get this in a textbook, or they cannot get this like at like school, because it's not their own home environment. So in there will be a real fire, then he's gonna be like prepared to do that. Yeah.
What sort of devices are you thinking that kids are going to use in your applications? Like, in terms of like AR technology, it's very expensive at this point. Parents might be comfortable with having their kids play around with expensive devices. Are you trying to work on ways to try to make cheaper devices that kids can use?
So the question is, which technology we're going to use and devices. So the way our target group is that now is like 3 to 9 years old, maybe 10, and the app is installed on the parents' phone. With this, they are controlling the kids, because like giving a kid go outside and be hit by a car, we don't want to take that responsibility. But like it's installed on the parents' phones and it's parenting app. So it's the whole family that's working on that. So it's not, they don't have their own devices, and it's only iOS for the moment. Thank you. Yes. So every game has their own content, every own like characters, and like Tutto Completo is different. Yeah.
So you say that you help kids socially interact. Does that mean you're actually allowing kids to interact inside a virtual world?
Yeah. So the way we're doing, we're going on social media, like this is the first step that we engage the parents to go outside and do things together. But then we have like, who's gonna catch the fox, or who's gonna do something together. So we always encourage them to do like common tasks, common challenges. So it's always engaging to get the kids outside. There's a question there. Can you repeat the question?
How's the kids experience with using this technology?
So the kids are like, the way they're doing, they're like in love with their avatars. This is the first thing, and they want to progress in the level. So we're still like now in development phase. So we have like a few stages, they're like competing, but we haven't finished the whole game to say. But it's much like better learning outcome. I can say like they're progressing 3 times faster than they were doing that in textbooks. We were testing that. We have for another question. Yeah.
How not to be like
so engaging as Pokemon Go, so having too much screen time. So the way we're doing, we're giving like them just a clue, and everything has to like run their imagination. So we say, go outside and find a cat. So meaning he has to go outside and explore in his whole environment. But the difference with Pokemon Go, you have to like go after one dot and find the Pokemon Go. So with us, they really have to think and not be so much on screen time. Thank you.